Hi there, welcome to Heart Smart Home Cooking. I'm Laura Mukon. Throughout the whole month of March, we are bringing you recipes from the Heart and Stroke Foundation of Manitoba because March is Nutrition Month. And with me is Amanda Nash. Now, you're a nutrition manager at the Heart and Stroke Foundation Manitoba here.
That's right.
And it's your job to come up with these great recipes and to help us with the hints to eat better, reduce sodium, and even cut some fat and cost, which we're going to get to later. Mm-hmm. But the recipe we're making today is tacos three ways.
Exactly, turkey tacos three ways. Okay, so let's get started, and I'm going to have you add 1 tablespoon of canola oil to the pot.
Okay, so canola oil is the oil of choice for the Heart and Stroke Foundation. It's a healthy heart oil. So can you tell us a little bit about why?
So canola oil is full of the unsaturated fats, which are the healthy fats that we want to get more of in our diet. So if we're looking at this comparison chart for canola oil, you can see that canola oil compared to other fat sources has more of the healthy fats, those unsaturated fats, which are shown in blue, orange, and yellow on the chart, and less of the saturated fats, which are the bad fats, the red fats on the chart.
You can hear the canola oil is nice and hot, so it's time to put the rest of these onions in. And what happens after we saute the onions in this recipe?
All right, so we have about 1 medium diced up onion here, and we're gonna wanna saute it for about 5 minutes so that it softens up nicely. At that point, we can add the rest of our spices. So we have 1 clove of garlic that has been minced up.
Okay.
I'm gonna let you get that out of there. Yeah. We have 1 teaspoon of paprika powder. 1 teaspoon of chili powder, 1 teaspoon of cumin, and then we just want to add a dash of pepper there to that. So between that garlic, onion, and all the different herbs and spices that we've added in there, we're going to get a homemade taco seasoning without adding any of that extra sodium. And this is a great part of the recipe where kids can get involved. Okay. They can measure out those spices for you, and you can explain the power of spice. Both the Heart and Stroke Foundation and the Canola Growers of Manitoba triple test these recipes because we want to make sure that they have excellent flavor, excellent taste, without having the excess sodium that is added with convenience foods or restaurant foods.
Okay, and so sodium is the next thing that we're really focusing on here, really trying to reduce the sodium.
Exactly. Yeah. So sodium is found in salt. It's a component of salt. Mm-hmm. And Canadians in general are eating more than half of the salt that their bodies actually need. Sodium is directly related to hypertension, which is a risk factor for heart disease and stroke. Mm-hmm. So we want to make sure that we can take steps to cut back on the sodium that we add to our foods when we're cooking.
And not only are our foods so heavy in salt to begin with, but then we add salts on top of it.
Yeah.
So it's crazy that our palates are so into salt. Mm-hmm. So it might take a little bit of training to get used to less salt, but since these recipes are triple tested, the taste is great anyways.
Exactly.
Okay, so what's happening next here?
All right, so now we want to add in our lean ground turkey. Okay. So we have 1 pound of lean ground turkey here. And we're going to need to saute this up for about 10 minutes until the turkey is no longer pink inside.
Okay. Oh, it really smells good so far. So the turkey is pretty much done here, and once it started cooking, it really got moist and all the spices have really come together, mm-hmm. and it smells amazing. It looks amazing, but there's still more ingredients here, and we're still talking about salt with these lentils.
Yeah, so we have drained and rinsed some canned lentils here. Now, adding canned lentils to our meal is a great meat alternative that is full of not only protein, but also soluble fiber. And we know that soluble fiber can help to control your blood cholesterols. The reason that we drained and rinsed the lentils before we added them in was to help decrease the salt in our product, in our food. So sometimes canned products can have more sodium in them. But as soon as you rinse them, you're gonna remove some of that sodium to make your meals a little bit healthier.
Okay, and as we were talking about before, there's all this extra salt in our diet.
And I think earlier I might have said that Canadians are consuming half the amount of sodium that our body needs. That's not true. Canadians are actually consuming double the amount of sodium that our body needs.
Wow, okay.
So it's a lot more than we actually want.
Yeah. And so at every step of the game, we're trying to cut that sodium, even just by doing an extra rinse of your lentils is a good idea.
Exactly.
Okay,
yep.
So next.
Now we're gonna add in some diced up green and red peppers. And I've diced up about half of each pepper here. Okay. So that means that you're gonna have half a pepper left over. You can slice those up at that point, throw them in the fridge in some bags, and you can use those for a snack or a future meal. So make your prep time of your next meal a little bit easier for you.
Okay, and so putting this all together, It's already colorful. There's already lots of vegetables and good stuff going on here. But you definitely need a good cooking utensil to work with all of these ingredients.
That's true.
And the Heart and Stroke Foundation of Manitoba has a great prize this year, something new that you guys are doing. And this is part of the prize. So can you tell us a little bit about the contest and how people can enter?
Sure. So this year, you can enter to win a Heart Smart home cooking package. And in that package, like you said, this spatula is one of the prizes, along with some other utensils and cooking equipment that can make cooking easier in your own kitchen.
Okay, so coming up in a few minutes, we will have all that information at the end of our show. So grab a pen and a piece of paper now, because we'll also give you information about the Heart and Stroke Foundation, the contest, and how to find these recipes.
Mm-hmm. Great, so after cooking this for about 3 to 4 minutes, so that all those vegetables get nice and soft, we are ready to go and make our wrap.
So this is the really fun part, and we were talking about this earlier. Neither of us really say that we're great at making wraps, but this is a good part to get the kids involved, because that is a huge, huge message with the Heart and Stroke Foundation of Manitoba this year, every year, is getting the family involved and why that matters.
Mm-hmm, exactly. So this is a really fun recipe that the kids can get involved in. And we all know that families that eat together tend to eat healthier. Families that eat together have been shown to have less trans fat, less saturated fat, less sodium, and more fiber in their diet. And those are all key tips to help reduce the risk of heart disease and stroke, and also to maintain a healthy weight. So when we compared this recipe to similar recipes from convenience foods or from restaurant foods, we found that our recipe actually had half of the amount of fat and less than half of the amount of sodium compared to those other food products.
Well, it's great to have a recipe you can trust. And it's amazing to know that kids who learn about cooking and practice cooking end up eating better. That's an amazing statistic and a good one to remember.
And not only that, but actually kids who are involved in the meal-making process and eating family meals have been shown to do better in school. They learn their family values and traditions, and they also learn the life skills of cooking so that when they grow up and they get older, they can still cook healthy, nutritious meals for themselves.
So take a look at this chart again, just because I know you personally have gone out and scoured restaurants and grocery stores to find this information. And this is a real handy way to break down a recipe per serving and come away with all those extra health benefits.
Exactly.
So we are going to attempt the wrap here, but the wrap is only one of three ways that we can prepare this recipe.
You're right. So our recipe is called Turkey Tacos Three Ways. And the wrap is one way. Another way is to use the traditional hard corn tortilla shells. Mm-hmm. And the third way is actually a great way to use leftover turkey mixture.
Okay.
And that is a turkey taco salad.
Oh.
So let's get started with this wrap. And the first thing we're going to need to do is grate our cheese.
Okay.
So I have a reduced fat Monterey Jack cheese here. And we're going to be adding about 2 teaspoons into our wrap.
So with all of these, I see we also have lettuce and tomato here. Will this count as a full meal according to the food guide?
Yeah, it sure will. Okay. So if we add about 4 tablespoons of filling into our wrap, or 2 tablespoons of filling into each tortilla or each corn shell, mm-hmm. then 2 of those hard tacos or 1 wrap is going to have all 4 of the food groups, and it's going to be an excellent balanced meal.
Okay, so I guess this is next.
Yeah, so about 4 tablespoons into the wrap.
This is where I make the mistake. I add tons. So all along the line.
Yeah, I think you could probably add another one there.
Okay.
Perfect.
This is why I eat my wraps with a knife and fork, because they just don't stay together for me. Okay, next.
So now we can top that with some lettuce, some shredded lettuce, and some tomatoes, diced up tomatoes. At this point, if you wanted to add some lower fat sour cream or some salsa, that's your choice. It's up to you. And then we're all done. All we have to do is wrap this up, and then you're ready to go, ready to eat.
Oh, you're good. That looks like a wrap to me already.
Just don't let it go or it might fall apart.
Perfect. Well, thanks so much, Amanda.
No problem.
Special thanks to the Manitoba Canola Growers Association and to Cargill for helping bring Heart Smart Home Cooking to viewers across the province. If you would like to get a copy of today's recipe, or if you'd like to enter the Heart and Stroke Foundation of Manitoba's Heart Smart Home Cooking Contest, you can click on heartandstroke.mb.ca or phone 949-2000 in Winnipeg, or toll free at 1-888-473-4636.